Welcome to a probability example that involves the use of combinations. A company employs 5 men and 7 women. 3 employees are selected at random to attend a conference. Find the probability the employees selected will consist of, first, 3 women, then 2 men and 1 woman, then 1 man and 2 women. For reference, we have the definition of probability and a combination listed here below in red. To find the probability of each event, we want to determine the number of favorable ways and divide by the total number of ways the employees can be selected. So for the first probability, the probability of selecting 3 women, since there are a total of 7 women and we're selecting 3 employees, the favorable number of ways of selecting the 3 women would be 7 choose 3. We know it has to be a combination because the order of the selection does not matter as long as all 3 are women. And then for the total number of ways that 3 employees can be selected from a total of 12 employees would be 12 choose 3. This quotient would give us a probability of selecting 3 women. Now for the next step, we'll evaluate these combinations by hand and then check them on the calculator. So if we have n choose r, this is equal to n factorial divided by n minus r factorial, which means for 7 choose 3, we would have 7 factorial divided by 7 minus 3 factorial, that's 4 factorial, and then 3 factorial. So let's go ahead and expand 7 factorial, but then we'll stop at 4 and write it as 4 factorial. So 7 factorial is equal to 7 times 6 times 5 times, we'll stop here because we have a 4 factorial in the denominator, so write this as 4 factorial. Our denominator is 4 factorial, and 3 factorial would be 3 times 2 times 1. So in this form, 4 factorial over 4 factorial simplifies to 1, 2 times 3 is 6, and 6 over 6 would simplify to 1, leaving us with 7 times 5, or 35. Now let's do the same for 12 choose 3. We would have 12 factorial divided by 12 minus 3 is 9, so we have 9 factorial, 3 factorial. So we'll write 12 factorial as 12 times 11 times 10 times 9 factorial. We're stopping here because we have a 9 factorial in the denominator. And 3 factorial would be 3 times 2 times 1. So 9 factorial over 9 factorial simplifies to 1. 2 times 3 is equal to 6, and 6 divides evenly into 12. So these two factor out, and the 12 would simplify to 2. So we're left with 2 times 11 times 10, which would be 220. So this would be the probability of selecting 3 women. But when expressing probability as a fraction, we should simplify as much as possible. These both contain a common factor of 5, so if we divide them both by 5, our simplified probability as a fraction would be 7/44. Now, probability can also be expressed as a decimal or percentage. Let's also do that. 7 divided by 44 would be approximately 0.1591. To convert this to a percentage, we would multiply by 100. So this would be approximately 15.91%. Now, I also mentioned we would evaluate these combinations on the calculator. So let's go ahead and check our work. To evaluate 7 choose 3 on the calculator, we'll first press 7, then math, left arrow to probability. Option 3 is combination. And now we'll enter 3 for 7 choose 3. So notice that is 35, and now we'll evaluate 12 choose 3. So again, 12, math, left arrow, option 3, and then 3, enter. 220, which verifies our work is correct. For the second example, we want to find the probability of selecting 2 men and 1 woman. So for this probability, the denominator, or the total number of ways of selecting 3 people, is going to be the same. That's going to be 12 choose 3, But then for the numerator, with a favorable number of ways of selecting two men from five men would be 5 choose 2 times, this is the counting principle, the number of ways of selecting one woman from 7, that would be 7 choose 1. Well, we already know the denominator is 220. Now let's go and evaluate 5 choose 2 and 7 choose 1 by hand. Well, 5 choose 2 is equal to 5 factorial divided by 3 factorial 2 factorial. So we'll write 5 factorial is 5 times 4 times, well, we have a 3 factorial in the denominator, so we'll have 3 factorial divided by 3 factorial 2 factorial, which is 2 times 1. So 3 factorial with 3 factorial simplifies to 1. 4 and 2 simplify. There's 1, 2, and 2, and 2 2s and 4. So 5 choose 2 is equal to 10. We really shouldn't have to work out 7 choose 1. If we have 7 people and we're choosing one person, there would be 7 ways to do that. So our numerator is 10 times 7, which would be 70. So 70 divided by 220, common factor of 10. So as a fraction, the probability would be 7 over 22. Let's go and convert this to a decimal and a percentage. So 7 divided by 22 would be approximately 0.3182. Multiplying by 100, this would give us 31.82%. And now for the last example, we're going to determine the probability of selecting one man and two women. Well, again, our denominator is going to stay the same. That's going to be 12 choose 3. Now we're selecting one man from 5. That's 5 choose 1 times the number of ways of selecting two women from 7. That would be 7 choose 2. Again, we already know that 12 choose 3 would be 220. Well, we should recognize that 5 choose 1 would be 5. And just due to time, 7 choose 2 is equal to 21. So this would be 105 all over 220. Common factor of 5, so this simplifies to 21 over 44. Let's go and convert this to a decimal and a percentage. So 21 divided by 44, it's going to be approximately 0.4773, which as a percentage would be approximately 47.73% by multiplying the decimal by 100 and adding the percent symbol. Okay, I hope you found these three examples helpful. Thank you for watching.